Hi there, and it's a warm welcome to Vint-tro. I hope you're well. Apologies again, it's been a little while since we've got out a video. It's been a little bit hectic, but we've got some good content coming up, so hopefully we should be able to get a few more regular videos out. But today is a short video talking about a car I know particularly well, because I own it. And it's a car which, unfortunately, I've not used as much as I hoped. My wife and I had a beautiful son called Joseph, who's came up to two in June. And having the three of us just means I'm not using the car as much, just having two seats. So the decision is, and I'll be taking on the journey as I explore some four or two plus two cars. But in the meantime, I've got the pleasure of showing you my Aston Martin Vantage. Welcome to Vint-tro.com, your automotive hub for exclusive discounts on services and products which we've personally approved, plus access to events and also cars for sale before they go on to open market sale, but also all our blogs and vlogs in one place. So sign up for free and get exclusive discounts across all these range of services at Vint-tro.com. So this is my 2007 Aston Martin Vantage. It is a 4.3 litre, which is obviously the original engine which came with the Vantage. But I'm not really going here to talk about the stats of the car and driving experience and so forth. I'm here to talk about my ownership experience, which has been just over 3 years. Have a walk around the car, talk about its specs in terms of what's actually on this car itself. And finally, it's talk about selling it and the reasons why I'm selling it, but also to talk about the journey if I do sell it and what cars I'll be looking at next. So let's have a good walk around this car and just have a talk about it. So it's probably around about 4 years ago when I started to search for my next car. I've mainly had new, I've mainly had BMWs and M cars, but I've decided after many years of, to be fair, losing my arse on buying cars and having a bit of a disagreement with Cooper Ipswich and what I have to class as horrendous management and the manager of the site, I started to get into buying and selling a few kind of modern classic cars, but I wanted something for myself, something which was special and a car which I could use on the weekends when it was lovely warm weather, but also a car to enjoy with my mates going out on road trips. And looking around and finding something which I felt was special, but also a car which I also knew was probably at its bottom of its price. And with that, hopefully wasn't gonna lose any money, or if not, try and maybe sell it for the same price I bought it for. I was never gonna think about trying to buy it to make money out of it. It's just not something which was really gonna be the main focus. But when searching the market, the V8 Vantage seemed to be that kind of perfect car. You know, nothing beats the brand Aston Martin. Nothing can beat that noise. To be honest with you, I'm not about top speed. I'm not a fast driver. Yeah, I enjoy a few little blasts here and there, but I'd rather have a car which sounds amazing at 30 than a car which you have to absolutely rag the nuts out of. And with that, you get the noise, but also you lose your driving license. And this kind of felt like the perfect car for me because the noise is amazing, and being the 4.3 litre, which yeah, everyone says isn't the quickest, but to be fair, looking at a little bit of the stats, you know, it goes 175 miles per hour, top speed, it's got 380 brake horsepower, and a 0-60 at 4.9 seconds. So to be fair, it's not, yeah, it's not the quickest, but also it's not slow. But the great thing being the 4.3 litre is that you get that noise all the time. And also, I've done the fuse delete, which means the valves are open, and I do get the noise all the time. But also, I get a few pops and bangs when I'm going down the gears. So it has all the drama, all the noise, and it does sound absolutely bloody amazing. So I started to look at a few cars online, and there was a lot about. I thought I wanted to get a car which was a bit more limited in colour. Toro red was one of them, which is the same as my colleague Simon's car. But after looking around and realizing that, you know, I know grey was the colour which kind of, well, I think was very popular at the time. But when I saw this car in the tungsten silver, I realised this was the colour for it. If I go slightly closer, you can just see this kind of heavy, deep metallic, lots of fleck in there. And what I just love is just how it just picks up the light, all the dark spots. It just, as I say, it just looks amazing. And really, you got to see this in person to really understand why, for me, this feels like the perfect colour for the V8 Vantage. So I bought the car from the Ferrari Centre down in Maidstone in Kent, a company which is formerly known for their work with Ferraris, and they've been in existence for 37 years. So I'd absolutely trust that I was buying from a company which knows their cars and have absolute trust in. It came with a full service history from Aston Martin in 7/8, which is Jardine's. It'd been well looked after, and also James, the salesman from the Ferrari Centre, had done an exceptional job when it comes to looking at all the history and organising it neatly within the pack, which I could see every receipt, every penny spent on it. And there has been a lot of money spent on this car. It's not because of servicing, but it's because of various body modification parts and interior parts, which I'll be going through a little bit later in this video. So I knew I had a car which had been well looked after, and I had confidence in buying it from a garage which I know would look after me. So I went down, met with James the salesman, he showed me around the car, and with that I could see that there's been a lot of money spent on this. I think in total, with all the receipts, there'd been about £12,500 spent on various carbon fibre, the N400 side seals. So yeah, it was special. It wasn't just the bog standard 4.3. And it was a little bit different to other cars which I've been looking at. I also knew the car itself was very honest. There'd been no work to it, done to it in terms of body-wise. It hadn't been shunt or anything at all like that. It had a few little kind of stone chips. You might see just one there. And just a few little marks from obviously being a car which, as I say, was produced in 2007. It was in incredible condition with no dents or dings or anything at all like that. So, as I say, it had been incredibly well looked after. It also came with the 007 number plate, which some people might call a bit cheesy, but to be fair, it's quite cool. And also brings a few smiles to people's faces when they do see it. It didn't come with the matching tungsten silver wheels, and that's something which I've had done in the last 3 months, and as I say, the car itself has only done probably about 80 odd miles on these new wheels. So, as I say, they're pretty much like new, and I thought it'd be nice just to have the kind of contrasting black centre badge. Again, it's a true Aston Martin part. Also, I knew that the car had been protected very well over the years because it had PPF within various areas, not on the body itself, but on the lights, the wing mirrors, and also just on the rear arch here, just so to make sure that the body is protected within those kind of key areas. So after a few negotiations, the car was mine, and it was 3 years ago at the end of March. I had the car collected and transported back home. I would say that my start of my life with this car wasn't perfect. There's a small knocking noise which came from the engine. And I spoke to the garage and they said, good God, okay, right, fine, get it back to us, which they did. They had it checked over by Aston Martin, and Aston Martin said, that's just how it sounds. But I've got friends with Aston Martin Vantages. I listen to their cars, they listen to mine. And they said, yeah, something doesn't quite sound right. So off it went back again, and you know, there was a bit of a back and forth with Richard from the Ferrari Centre. We looked a bit online, read a few blogs, and found one for Piston Heads where it was noted that there could be a little bit of clearance with the shims. And lo and behold, when we got the head off and we checked it, that three of the shims had a little bit more clearance than the others, which was kind of causing the noise. Also, when Richard looked at the part numbers for these three shims, they had different part numbers to the others. And also, the part numbers on those three shims were actually old part numbers, where the other ones had the kind of up-to-date part numbers, which again could be the reason why there was a clearance issue. Anyway, they were swapped out and perfect, back to normal, or back to what it should have sounded like. But it was just strange that basically from the first owner of this car up until obviously the owner before I bought it, they'd all lived with this kind of small knocking noise, which, as I say, it's strange why they've not picked it up, but yeah, it's something which I knew wasn't right, and I want to get sorted. And once that was sorted, I knew I had a very special version of this Aston Martin Vantage. Following that, as I say, I've not had an issue, apart from on return of the first ever Vint-tro road trip. I quickly shot home, had to swap cars because I was out for dinner that evening. And when I went to then move the car again, the battery was dead. Well, I thought the battery was dead. Actually, it was the starter motor. So what happened is the starter motor is positioned quite close to the exhaust manifold. And long and short of it is carbon builds up, and with that, then the starter motor doesn't work. Normally, when this happens in a car, you give it the starter motor a bit of a knock, and it starts working again. But this issue is you can't get to the starter motor to do that. So it did go back to Fry Center again, and they reconditioned the starter motor. There's no need to replace it because, to be fair, there wasn't an issue at all with it. And ever since then, not had a single problem. And actually, since then, I've not had a single problem with the car at all. It's been faultless. You know, it's been well looked after by its previous owners, and also it's been well looked after by me. It's gone for its annual service at Aston Martin Cambridge, which is also Jardine's, so they're able to pick up the previous service history from Sevenoaks. And they've taken it in, and obviously anything which need doing to it, they've done, which was zero. They've serviced it, they've looked around the car, they've done their videos, and they've also stated that, yeah, this is a very, very well looked after car. So it's just had its regular oil change and service, and that's it. So, yeah, as I say, for anyone who wants an Aston Martin, this is a car which I know personally from owning it is just not going to be a problem when it comes to kind of ongoing maintenance. Yet, I'm sure at some point in the future, like Aston Martins do, little things come up. You know, I get the emission service light come up on the dashboard. Admittedly, that hasn't come up now for probably about a year and a half, but that's a fun thing which ever happens so often if you don't, in my instance, if I don't tighten up the petrol cap properly, that just triggers a sensor. But if I take it out for a good long drive, or if I fill the fuel up to the brim, that emission service light turns off. So yeah, just a little bit of quirk of owning this car. And actually, it's quite funny, on the Aston Martin Vantage Facebook group, you see a lot of new owners who first have the experience of that light turning on. The first thing they do is take a picture and they ask, is this a problem? Is this normal? And pretty much every owner on there says, yeah, this is just a quirk of owning the car, and something which comes up ever so often. So yeah, it's just something funny which you have to live with by owning a V8 Vantage. So just to kind of go through some of the exterior features on the car. One small upgrade on the exterior is the brake calipers, which are done in, matching body color, but done in gray. So that is an option. Another option are these 19 spoke wheels. Again, they did come with the car, but they were added extra. But in terms of what one of the owners did, actually I found his Piston Heads blog from when they actually did the work, or made to the exterior work. But he actually, as I say, was the person who spent £12,500 on this car. That included the N400 side sills, which I love. Some people might like the original 4.3 litre side steels, where they more kind of tuck in, so you get more of a haunch on the arch. But I actually like how this looks, and when you stand back for the car just seems to kind of just see a bit more hunkered, a bit more wider, and just has a slightly better stance. They also put on a carbon fibre, you see there, rear diffuser, which just looks stunning from the rear. Does transform the back of this car, and I think just makes it look a little bit more modern, but yeah, everyone loves carbon fibre, and I think that really does suit the car. And then on the front of the car, we have a carbon front splitter, which you can see there, it's just zooming in, which just sticks out a little bit further than the normal black little splitter you get on the front of the car, but just adds a really lovely little touch. So, going inside the car, it's good if I actually opened it up. We are greeted by a full carbon step-in or kick sealed or whatever you want to call it, which does look bloody good. The one thing which the owner did put on this, and I've not taken it off just because I don't know if it's going to have the original plug underneath there or not, but he's put on this V8 Vantage carbon edition. There was a carbon edition of the V8 Vantage S, or V8S should I say. This isn't it, and yeah, each to their own, but yeah, it's not something which I would have picked to put on the car. Also, we've got carbon fiber on the door here, and I did note actually from his vlog, it did have carbon fiber here, which I think is the same as what's on the DBS, but thankfully that was removed. I think if we had carbon fiber on there as well, it's probably a bit too much. We've also got a full carbon steering wheel, which I've had rewrapped in Alcantara. It was in Alcantara previously, which was black. It was just a bit dirty over time. So I've had that done in this dark grey, which I think really suits the car, with white stitching, which also matches the large white stitching on the seats and on the centre and on the doors. So just neatly all tie things in. Then on the inside, we have the carbon fiber waterfall, which really makes a statement in here. I just love that. So lovely finished here. And when you bring in the carbon fiber, it zooms into the steering wheel, it just really lovely ties in. And then we've got the DBS, or what was on the V12 Vantage gear knob, which is just a lovely little finish. I love the fin of this gear knob. I know your little stubby ones, yeah, a bit Marmite. I've not owned a V8 Vantage with a stubby one, so I can't say if this is better or worse, but I would say in your hand, just feels lovely. A bit cold now, because it's not very warm today. And yeah, there's been a couple of occasions on a really hot day where, yeah, you're changing gears quite quickly because this does get a little bit hot, but it just looks pretty good. Really, really does. You're probably aware from watching some videos, it's got the sat nav, which is as useless as the chocolate fire guard, so that never opens. I never open that up. I was tempted to speak to Aston Installations and look at getting the upgrade to have Apple CarPlay. To be honest with you, if, as I say, I am planning to sell this car, and I'll go for the reasons why very shortly. If I don't get what I want for the car, then I might keep it and spend the small amount of money to get that all upgraded. Because, as I say, once that's done, you've pretty much got the perfect car. You've got some modern tech in there, you can play your music, you can get Waze on there, and then you've got that noise. You've just got the unbelievable noise, which, to be fair, you don't need a stereo when you've got that blowing it behind you.
So inside we've got this lovely kind of silvery grey lining which goes lovely with the car. We've got leather everywhere, typical Aston Martin. It's just finished. Such a high quality finish. The one thing which, if I go back here, one thing which Kent Performance Cars did, they just wired in the trickle charger, which I've got a C-Tech, so nice and easy just to plug it in. Yeah, there's a little bit of wear on the bolster here. The one thing which I've been meaning to do is I use regular basis put some leather moisturizer in here, which is why the seats look so good, but I think I just might apply a bit more there. But otherwise, this car is pretty much bloody immaculate. As I say, I love any care with it. It's detailed on a regular basis. It's stored indoors. It's got a bit wet on a road trip, but apart from that, that's the only time when actually it gets any amount of water on it, apart from when it's being cleaned. So it truly has been kind of cared for and loved by myself and all the previous owners. Right, we'll go around the other side, and what we'll do is we'll look at opening up the bonnet. So just got the latch down here. And then catches just there. And there we have it. 4.3 litre V8. So I mentioned before in the video, there is the argument between the 4.3 and the 4.7. You can pay quite a jump in price for the 4.7. Yes, it's a little bit quicker, but I'll be honest with you, I'm not about the speed, I'm about the pleasure, the drama and the noise. And for me, this car is plenty for what I need. I can go 30 and it sounds immense, and I get everything I want from the car going slowly, because I know that I've got that noise at my fingertips, to be fair, whenever I want. So you can pay the extra premium for the 4.7 if you want something a little bit quicker, but if you just love the noise of an Aston Martin, this is plenty enough. Has a lovely little badge on there, so if any of you current Vantage owners have a car made by Andrew Goff, or if you are Andrew Goff and you're watching this video, this is one of your cars still being used and still being loved. Alright, we'll go down to the rear. So you have a little button here, or you can double click on the key fob to open up the bonnet. And yeah, here it is. Nothing much special here. Holds enough for a nice long weekend. But otherwise, yeah, it's, to be fair, it's a reasonably decent boot. So I mentioned that I'm planning to sell this because mainly it's because I don't use it as much as I hope. My wife and I had a beautiful little boy called Joseph, who's coming up to 2 in June. Lockdown hasn't helped in terms of getting out there and using the car. But the one thing which, when we came out of lockdown one, if it was a nice hot day, we went out as a family and this car wasn't being used. And all I wanted to do was just to get this out and just hear that engine and just kind of just feel the drama. So after some long deliberation and also some kind of heavy research, which I've actually done a blog on this, so I'll put the link down below to my blog on the Vint-tro website. I've decided that if I get the right money for the car, and I'll be honest with you, I've looked around, and if I wanted, or if I regretted selling this car, it's going to be, well, to be fair, I won't find one at the spec with the level of carbon. And obviously with the side seals, I just won't. And also a car which I know inside out and I have absolute confidence in terms of its reliability. So I'm not in a position where I want to rush and selling it, and two,
I don't have to sell it, but the truth of the matter is I don't want to have the money sat in this car and also in another car. So I'd rather sell it and then move that money on onto my next car. But basically, if I get the right money, I will sell it. And with that, I'll get a 2+2. So a car which I can enjoy with my wife and also my son, and try and use it a bit more on those lovely hot days. You'll see on the blog, actually my main contender is a DBS. I would be tempted to get one of those, which is a DB9. But I think just having this car and having something which is a little bit different to a standard, I think a DBS is going to be the better car for me. So I'm very tempted to keep within the Aston Martin family. And actually, I think the number plate will probably suit that car better. So the plate doesn't come with the car, will be transferred onto my next car. So yeah, with absolute regret, this car might be going. But what it means is that if someone is out there looking for a V8 Vantage, one very, very lucky person could own this. And I do really mean it. I'm not selling this, because to be fair, I'm not in a rush to selling it. But the truth of the matter is that if someone is looking to get a Vantage, you're not going to get much better than this. It's done 37,900 miles, which I feel is probably about the right amount for ownership of this car to make sure that it's being used and loved without being, as I say, being a high mileage. I've had the discs and brakes checked, plenty of meat on there. There's around about 5mm of tread on the tyres, so no issues there at all. And also the clutch has got plenty on it. It's the one thing which I had checked over with Kent High Performance, and also I've had checked over by Aston Martin. And the one thing which I've noted is that this has been driven well, in the sense of that someone hasn't ridden the clutch. There's very little clutch wear. People use this kind of card of, or if you're buying this car, you've got to make sure that it's had a clutch change. Yes, if it's been driven hard and you can feel the clutch is slipping, of course you've got to change the clutch. A friend of mine, he's got one of these with 26,000 miles, and he was aware that the previous owner used to ride the clutch because, well, you could smell it. And that clutch does need replacing. But the truth of the matter is, if it's driven properly, and I've made sure that I've not ridden the clutch at all, it's going to last. But then again, whoever buys this next, if they decide to ride the clutch, well, lo and behold, you're going to have to replace it at some point soon. So that in itself isn't a problem whatsoever. It is due a service. It was due a service back in March, I think it was. It's been in storage, which is where it is now. And I've been trying to get it booked in with Aston Martin Cambridge. They are brilliant. Part of their service is that they come and collect the car. I don't live particularly close, and it's not convenient to drive it there. So it is waiting to be serviced, if someone buys it beforehand, of course there's a bit of movement on the price if you want to service yourself, but otherwise it'll come with a service. It's just been MOT'd, flew through, not an issue at all, so it's got a nice fresh MOT with it as well. So again, whoever buys this car really has to want for nothing. They'll turn up, take the keys, and enjoy probably a good 12 months with no costs up until the next service. And of course it's up to them if they want to continue with having a full Aston Martin service history. The truth of the matter is, and if I look at the history, which I do have to say, another good thing with high performance cars, they did put into a spreadsheet the dates and the mileage of every service and every MOT on this car. And apart from the first two owners, which, you know, put probably 2,000 to 4,000 miles on this per annum, it didn't need a service. They say have it done every 12 months or every 10,000 miles. And the truth of the matter is, I'm sure the oil which they're taking out of this car is as clean as the oil going in. Because as I say, it's just not doing many miles to warrant having an annual service. But again, at least it's been looked after, at least it's had that annual service, and at least it's been checked over by Aston Martin to make sure that if anything does come up, anything needs doing, it has been done. And I've seen with the receipts that, yeah, there's been general maintenance things which have been done, just the general wear and tear of this car. But it's been lovely looked after. All the money has been spent on it when it needs to. And that has meant that, you know, when I bought it 3 years ago, I was incredibly lucky. I had the couple of little glitches which both myself and Kent High Performance dealt with between ourselves. But to be fair, it was very minor. And actually, all these things happened during autumn, winter. So the car wasn't being used anyway. So from my perspective, it didn't really take away from my love for this car. So now the bonnet's down. I'm sure you want to hear this. Cold start with a fuse delete in a warehouse. It's going to sound good. Car in its glory, all turned on. So the upgraded kind of blue lights in here, which look quite nice. But you've got to say, what a cabin. That engine just purrs. Really does sound amazing. Okay, well, the car's been on now for a little bit. Yeah, let's get a bit of a rev here. I just love that noise. There you go. There's the mileage. 37,912 miles. Yeah. So, a really, really, really special car. And yeah, the more I think about when I talk about selling it, to be honest with you, no, I don't want to sell it, and I want to keep it. But I need to keep my wife happy. Just another, pretty nice in the background, a few little cool cars we've got here. So yeah, if you are in the market, and if you are looking for a Vantage, I'm not looking for any sob stories. I'm not looking for any dealers wanting to do a deal. I will leave my email address below. And if you are truly interested and you want a car which, as I say, has got all the carbon fibre in the right places and has been well looked after and you've got absolute peace of mind, please do get in contact. And obviously, as I say, I will send you across a list of all the details. I'll also just take a few photographs, any close-ups, any bits and pieces if you want me to. But otherwise it's down at the Vint-tro hangar for people to view. Obviously COVID rules will make sure that you know, safe distance and all the rest of that, so we'll make sure that we will be safe. I should also add that the car could come with its made to size car cover, which also has some cool branding, Aston Martin on the front and Barge on the side, and yeah, even has a bit of an extension for the top of the car for the aerial. Okay guys, well that's the end of the video. I hope you enjoy the walk around the car, and also I hope that maybe one of you might be interested in buying it. So please get in contact, I'll be happy to send more details to you, and yeah, you never know, you might be driving this car one day. But don't think this is the end of the journey. Once the car is sold, I will be taking with me to look at the cars listed in my blog, which I'll leave the link down to that blog below. And you'll see how I go through the process of testing these cars. Could be unusual, because also I'll be testing it with a baby seat to see how these 2+2s work. But I'm also gonna ask is, if there's a car on that list which I should be looking at, please leave a comment below, because I'll be gladly add it to my list for me to start testing. So it's a big thank you for me, and it's a big thank you for Vint-tro, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Peace and love.